Welcome back to Tutorial Tidbits. I'm Elizabeth St. Hilaire, and this is a special edition tidbit, and I am cheers to my brand new stencil designs. I've got 9 new designs with joggles.com. They are 9x12 and they are all in a peacock theme. They have been under wraps for the past couple of weeks as we've been working on them, but today they're officially available for purchase at joggles.com. If you are interested in a quick link, check out the upper right-hand corner, whichever way that is, of your video, or visit joggles.com, and also I'll put the link below. These stencils have been a lot of fun for me because my love of Art Nouveau and the peacock theme is always has always been very close to my heart because of Art Nouveau. Also, my first tattoo ever in my life was a peacock, so there's that. Anyway, this week, the special edition, I'm going to be working with dark colors and interference colors and some pearlescent colors. So normally I layer from light to dark, but today, as a special tidbit, I'm going to show you the new stencils with some a layering of dark to metallic light. So if you've got a few minutes, let's go check out my 9 new stencil designs with joggles.com, the Peacock Collection. Welcome back. So I've been playing with my new Peacock Collection stencils. That is the theme of this collection of 9 new stencils that I've designed for joggles.com. So I've got 9 new designs, and they are all unique and different, and yet they all play well together. So I wanted to show you some of the things that I've been creating, and I'm working with dark colors, metallics, and iridescence. So what I've been working with out here is some nice dark phthalo blue green shade. I'm working in peacock colors. I've got some anthraquinone blue. I've got some interference blue, which is like a shimmery sort of a taffeta effect. You turn it one way and it looks blue, you turn it the other way and it doesn't look quite so blue. It's a translucent transparent. I'm going to show you that. I'm using iridescent bronze. I'm using some Van Dyke brown to darken down my colors and get them deep and rich. And I'm using some turquoise phthalo. This is quite the balancing act, isn't it? I've also experimented a little bit with some iridescent pearl fine. That's more like a silver, but translucent. It's a little different than interference, but it's not quite a silver paint. You can see that it's metallic, but that it is translucent by the way that you can see these black tick marks through the swipe of paint on the front of the label. Some of the other interference colors that I experimented with while I was playing is interference green blue, as well as interference violet green. I've decided though that my favorite is the interference blue, and so I'm going to show you that in this demo. But to show you what I've been creating while I've been out here, this one is created from the stencil called Eyes on You, and it was just layered over itself from dark to medium to metallic. So that's the Eyes on You stencil, and I'm going to use that in this demo. This one is a similar layering, and this one is called Ruffled Feathers. And so you can see that I've got the interference blue, the dark blue with Van Dyke brown, and then copper on top, giving me this lovely sort of iridescent pattern. This one is a particular favorite of mine. This one is called Feather Repeat, and this is a beautiful combination of phthalo teal, turquoise phthalo, I'm sorry, turquoise phthalo with the iridescent pearl mixed with turquoise phthalo. So I made myself a shimmery metallic of the phthalo over the dark phthalo. And that again is the feather repeat pattern. I really like that one. This next one, I'm going to call them all my favorites, right? This next one is called Undulation. This is the interference blue over the anthraquinone blue darkened down with the Van Dyke brown. So again, that's that beautiful interference blue. It's over, interference looks the most intense over dark
colors. So you can see this is very shimmery and metallic, and it shows up the best over dark colors. So this one is called Undulation. It's got some great swirly lines and circles in it. The next one I'm going to show you is called The Dance. And this one is anthraquinone blue over the copper mixed with turquoise phthalo. So it's a little bit metallic, not very much. And it's Undulation. And this one is dark over light. The next one is a lot of fun. The next one is called Plumage. And here I've got the Interference, so you can see that it's very metallic when we turn it to the light, and it's a little less metallic when it's away from the light. You can see like that. So you get sort of a taffeta effect with the Interference, depending on the angle that you look at it. So this is Undulation with the Interference green over the medium blue. So that is a really nice effect with the Interference. And a fun mask. The next one is called Peacock Doodles. This is copper over the phthalo blue green shade. So phthalo blue green shade is more of like a nice rich blue, not as dark as the anthraquinone. And this is copper over that for the Peacock Doodles. That's a fun one. The next one is... Oh, this one is Undulation. So I gave you the wrong title. This one, I titled these and I can't even remember. This one is Improvisation. This one is Improvisation, and this one is Undulation. This one is Undulation. This one's kind of cool because it's got sort of the peacock tail stacked up here before it goes into the eye feathers. I like this one a lot. This is another of the green violet Interference over the dark blue. So again, with the Interference, you see it more when you turn it towards the light than when you don't. So you get sort of that taffeta effect. And this one is Undulation, and this one is Improvisation. So we've got two there. And then the last one, I just did the ghost print because this is a fun one. This is called Peacock Abstraction. And I just made a straight up ghost print so that you could see that even though it is an image of a peacock, because I wanted to have a signature mask for this collection. So this would be the one. It's the image of a peacock. It's got some of the peacock eyes and the feathers and some more sort of abstract peacock shapes. It's definitely something that you can make textures and patterns and tear up with, but it's also got a little bit of a recognizable object in the peacock, and this is the sort of the signature one for the collection. So that's the entire collection available for purchase today at joggles.com. Just search under Elizabeth St. Hilaire under the 9x12 stencils and masks. So today I'm going to be working on my favorite paper, which is the pad of rice paper. It's available on my Amazon resource page. That link is below. This pad has a smooth side and a rough side. The smooth side is facing up in the pad, and that is the side, the smooth, that you want to go down on the gel plate. Why do I love this pad? Because it's rice paper, but it's very highly durable. It's thick and durable, and it has that nice smooth side that will not stick. So please ignore my hands. They're filthy with paint and also very bruised on the top from my rafting trip, from holding on to the ropes in the rapids and having my hands smash. And they're getting better, but they sure do look terrible. Anyway, this is the pad. It's on my Amazon resource page. It's the only rice paper pad, or my favorite rice paper for the plate, because it's sturdy and it doesn't tear, and it has that smooth side which pulls off all the color. So here's what we're going to be working with. We're going to be working with the Eyes on You mask, as well as the Improvisation mask. They are both masks because the plastic forms the pattern. So a stencil is when the holes form the pattern, and a mask is when the plastic forms the pattern. So this is what we call a framed mask, because it has a frame around it to hold all the pieces and parts together. So it's still a mask, but it's a framed mask. And this one is sort of like a freeform mask. So in this, you get a nice freeform edge. So again, this is Eyes on You, and this is Improvisation. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a sheet of paper With that nice, deep, rich, dark base color. Normally I work from light to dark, but in these, because I'm using iridescent and metallics and they show up the best on dark colors, this is gonna be, we're gonna start with dark. So I'm gonna start with my my anthraquinone blue, which is a very dark, deep, dark blue, but I'm going to add additional Van Dyke brown to that so I can get it even richer. And then I'm going to add a little turquoise phthalo to that so I can get it a little bit in the peacock green family. So that's a lot of paint. I hope it's not too much, but this is going to give me a really deep, dark, rich sort of bluish teal, but it's going to be very dark, and that's what we want. So those three colors to blend it together in a nice dark layer. So rolling that out thin on the rice, on the gel plate, taking the rice paper with the smooth side down and just pulling a nice dark solid. I got a couple streaks in that, but it doesn't matter because this is my base layer. Probably should move this up a little bit so it's a little easier for you to see. If I was worried about that, I could come back in and get another little bit of the turquoise phthalo using the same brayer that's still got some of the other dark colors in it, rolling it out. And let's just give it another layer so we can get and make sure it's nice and solid coverage, dark and rich. And we got a lot of paint on there now, so it's not coming off. So usually when that happens, let's use this. Why not? We'll just use this to pick up some of the any leftover paint. All right, so I've got my nice deep dark base layer, and the next thing I'm going to use is that interference blue. Now, I'm using two different brayers. I've got six inch brayers here. Since this one has got all the deep, dark blue paint in it, rather than wash that off or clean it or roll it out and try to make sure every last bit of that paint is off, I've got a second brayer that I'm using just for the metallics and the interference. It is a luxury to be able to use two brayers, but it sure is nice. Normally, I'll use one for cool colors and one for warm colors, and then they don't cross-contaminate. But in this case, today, I'm using one for all my darks and one for my iridescence and metallics. So here's what happens. This beautiful interference blue is just a lovely sort of glowing medium blue color. We're gonna roll that out in a nice thin application, and we're gonna start with the Eyes on You mask, the freeform mask, and we're gonna put that down and we're gonna print. And you're gonna see how really nice and rich this comes out over the dark. So we're printing before you dismount. I always take a peek before I dismount and make sure that if I need to apply more pressure to get paint up, if it's not all off. There we go. And look at that. Look at how vibrant that interference looks over that deep dark background. And again, if I tip it the right way, you can see it more or less depending on facing the light. So I've got a ghost print under here, but I'm not gonna really do much with that. So again, we'll use this as our cleanup sheet to sort of pull that off. A little bit of it is still left behind. So now I'm gonna use the pearlescent. So my iridescent pearl, I'm gonna put that out and I'm gonna put the turquoise phthalo into it so that I can make it a greenish iridescent rather than, if we just use this, it would be a pure, like a pearl iridescent white. But we're gonna take that iridescent brayer and we're gonna roll that together. So now we're creating sort of a teal iridescent by combining the iridescent pearl fine and the turquoise phthalo together right on the plate. Now I'm going to take the same Eyes on You mask and I am going to print it over itself in the opposite direction. So I want to make sure my circles are going the other way. So I'm going to flip this, flipping the paper so the print goes, so the eyes go in the opposite direction. So we're creating a kind of an interesting layering here. There, now we've got two layers of metallics. We've got that beautiful blue interference, and we've got the one we created with the pearlescence and the turquoise thalo. So now I've got two lovely layers that are on top of the dark. So again, I'm gonna just pull this. This time I'll print it on just a scrap sheet. Actually, let me show you something in the interim. This is a pretty good ghost print. So if I pull that up and let it dry for a minute or two, then I'm going to go over it with a dark color. So since that's pushing towards the thalo, the turquoise thalo, I'm going to put that over it. And we're running out of paint here. I'm not sure who's in charge of ordering paint. But we're going to put this paint right over that ghost print. We gave it a couple of seconds to dry, and now we're going to put that dark paint right over the ghost print that was left behind under the mask. That paint was trapped under the mask. We pulled the print, lifted up the mask, and that paint was still there. I let it dry for a couple seconds, and now I'm coating it with a darker color, the turquoise thalo, taking my rice paper smooth side down, a blank rice paper, and I'm going to pull a print. And the moisture from the turquoise thalo being added on top is going to allow the gel plate to release both layers. So this is sort of a secondary print to the process that we're already doing. So you see, again, sturdy rice paper, very sturdy because the plate is sticky. It's sticky, so you don't want to use too thin of a paper. Also, that smooth side really takes all the paint off. But here we've got sort of a beautiful iridescent, slightly more subtle ghost print that we pulled all in one print. So that's the Eyes on You mask with a ghost print pulled with the turquoise thalo. So an extra print in the process. So now back to this one. What we're going to do now is we're going to shift to the improvisation framed mask, and I'm going to layer that on top of this as my last layer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back to a darker color so that I can interrupt the light metallics that have appeared on top. So I'm going to come back with the turquoise thalo. No, I'm going to come back with the anthraquinone blue because we're really in a blue shade here. The blue, I'm going to let the green show through and it'll have the greenish tint because of that, but I want to bring blue at the end. So the anthraquinone blue, coming back to my dark blue brayer. I think I need a little bit more paint there. And then I have to decide whether I want to darken that down again with the Van Dyke brown. I don't think so. I think I want this top layer to be a little bit lighter. Not as dark as that, although it is pretty dark. So I think that's good though. But yeah, let's add some turquoise thalo if we can get any out. So I won't add the Van Dyke brown, but I will add the thalo. I do have that turquoise thalo in a high flow. I don't normally use high flow, but since I'm running out and I am blending it in with another color, I use high flow only when I blend it with a fluid acrylic, because otherwise a high flow by Golden, this is really an airbrush paint, and it is very, very liquidy. It has a ball in it. You shake it and there's a metal ball in there and you shake it up and it's really liquidy. So I don't generally use it, but if I mix it with a fluid acrylic color, then that gives it a little body. So that's making this a very dark bluish green. Now I am going to take the improvisation framed mask and I'm going to put that over the layers that I have established with the Eyes on You. So I'm coming back over the metallics and the iridescence with a top layer of dark. So the bottom layer was dark. Then we had two layers of metallic iridescent and the top layer is dark. And this top layer will break up some of the iridescent and bring it back to a nice layered look. So again, a lot of times I'm gonna peek and make sure I have enough pressure before I dismount the paper. And here you go, a luxurious, multi-layered, beautiful patterned peacock print using the two of the nine of the Peacock collection of stencils that are brand new for me. Now, this is fantastic. And while I've been working to create the process to show you this, here's another one made in a sort of a slightly different color palette, but exactly the same steps. This one leans more towards green. This one leans more towards blue. And then this one I did without the top improvisation stencil. So this one is just the eyes on you in all the steps. But I do like the way that the improvisation stencil sort of layers with the eyes on you. So this is really nice. Two different color palettes of that. The Peacock collection has 9 new stencils and masks. You're going to love them, and they are available for purchase today. So that link is below, and thank you so much for being here, and happy Wednesday. This is a bonus tutorial tidbit, so I guess I'll see you again at the end of the week.